All right, next event we have up is DDA, and DDA is Dramatic Duet Acting. It is cut from a play. It's a dramatic script involving two people. It's supposed to be a little intense, so if you're going to cry, that's okay. And that is pretty much it. We have Flowers and Lard. I'm sorry.
I can't believe it! You look incredible! You're so tan! How'd you get so tan in Minneapolis?
What are you doing out?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm just running some errands and things. So, what do you think of the place after 4 years?
I think you should be lying down.
Oh, don't worry about it. The doctor said I'll be fine if I don't move too fast.
But on the phone, you said it was an emergency.
Oh, it is an emergency.
You said you were laid up. I came all the way down here from Minneapolis because I thought you couldn't get out of bed.
Well, I have been laid up. It's just that...
What do you mean? You've been waltzing all over the room. If you've only got a small injury, then...
I broke my neck. Well, I chipped it. One of the little bones in the back. But the doctor said I could have been paralyzed for life. Really. I could have died.
You made me leave my work. You made me drive 4 hours because you chipped your neck.
Well, yes.
How'd you get hurt? This is ridiculous.
Someone tried to kill me. Conflict and strife often test the bonds of love. In this piece, Jo is left to care for her troubled mother while huge changes are occurring in her life. She struggles with the concept of freeing herself from her toxic situation and the frightening unknown without. Better the double you know than the one you don't.
Worried about her sister, Kes tries to convince Jo to leave her mother and start a new life with her. While struggling with her own problems, she's also trying to help her sister with hers. Independence by Lee Blessing. Kill you? Who?
Mom.
Mom tried to... Why didn't you say it over the phone?
Well, I couldn't say it over the phone.
Mom tried to kill you?
Well, yes. In a way, she hit me. And I fell 6 feet. Into the street. You know, over by Duman's Drug, where the street goes down? Well, it's a 6-foot drop and she pushed me.
You said she hit you.
Well, she did. But it was like a push. I mean, I fell over backwards. On my neck. I was almost hit by a Plymouth. I didn't wake up for a couple of minutes.
Did they see it? The person in the Plymouth?
Well, no. They were coming around the corner.
Did anybody see it?
No, it was Sunday, so the stores were closed. But it happened.
Why would Mom try to kill you?
Because I'm pregnant. So what do you think of the house? We painted it last year.
It's great to be home. But I can only stay a couple of days. I'm teaching 3 different courses.
Oh, well, I didn't expect you to stay long, honest. I just need you here for support. I need help with Mom and things. You know Mom.
Yes. I know Mom.
I need you to stand up to her. You know, like last time?
Last time? I committed her for 3 months. Is that what you're talking about?
Oh, no, no. I only meant that having all of her daughters here for once would help so much. Having all of her daughters to
contend with?
No, to love. Did you talk to her yet?
She asked if I was still a homosexual.
I'm not surprised. Cass, is it fun to be back?
Back with you?
Yeah, sure it's fun.
Well, how about the town and the people?
This town? These people?
Yeah.
Small town living isn't for me.
Well, you know. I think small towns are an important alternative to the stress of a contemporary urban life.
You do you?
How long can you stay? it's going to be such a relief to have you back. Really, I feel calm now. And Mom will be happier.
Not sure I believe that.
She will be, really. Yesterday she said it's a lovely thing when a family reunites.
She didn't say it to me.
But she said it to somebody. That's progress.
You call that progress, eh?
Oh, of course it is. It's not easy for her, you know. She has to go by little steps.
You know what I'd call progress? Real progress is if you were to decide, now that you're having a baby, to move up to Minneapolis with me.
What?
Come and live with me.
I couldn't do that.
Why not? Try and think about it rationally.
I don't have to think about it rationally. I couldn't do that.
Why not?
How could I leave Mom? What would happen to her? Tell me, what would happen?
She'd be all right.
She would? How?
She's managed for 53 years.
No, she hasn't. Not alone. She's always had someone to take care of her. First there was her family, then Dad, then you when Dad left, and now there's me. Well, who would be here when I left? Not Sherry. She'd be all alone.
So what?
So what?
I have a big place in Minneapolis. There'd be room for you, and my roommate wouldn't
mind. You've already asked your roommate? Jesus, Kes!
Well, I had to know.
Is that the only reason why you came down here? To steal me away from Mom?
No. I just thought
that... If you think for one second that I would leave Mom to move up there with you and that...
That what?
You know.
That Susan, you mean? That's her name. I think we should just drop it. That roommate, Susan, is the same as me. Our life is more normal than anything that goes on in this house.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
I know that I couldn't go up there and leave Mom. That's all.
Because she needs you.
That's right.
What for? What does she need you for?
Everything. She needs me to talk to her, to be with her, to listen to her, to be thinking about her. What does anybody need anybody for?
But shouldn't people sometimes change who they need?
But Mom's done that.
I don't mean Mom. I mean you.
We're getting off the point.
What do you need from Mom?
Nothing. I don't need anything from her. I help her and she doesn't help me, okay?
Something. You get something out of it?
Nothing. I don't get a thing. I give. That's my life. I give to people. There's nothing wrong with it. You should try it sometime.